to explore the actual swamp, which again is going to be a lot of me being poisoned. Might as well explore back here first, though.
At some point, you gotta kill that spider thing.
Wait, lag.
Yep. I really thought that was going to be a mimic there for a second.
You and me both.
It's just this little arena-looking spot by itself.
Actually, come to think of it, since I haven't really done anything yet, do I have enough souls to level up? Yes, I do. More dex. Of stuff out that way.
A lot of mosquitoes.
Yeah, it's like they're only hittable if you've let them come completely down to where you're at, which is really irritating because they like to occasionally fly back up.
Weird hitboxes on the mosquitoes. And there's an item.
Arch long proud knights.
Okay.
Titanite shards this time. Mosquitoes.
Another item. And some Sunny D.
Yep. Just not gonna bother curing the poison every single time because we're gonna just be blundering around the swamp a lot. Poison mist, and there's the pyromancer set. Which might be helpful in making the poison somewhat more manageable. Honestly, I should be wandering around here in the black leather set. It would help a bit with that. Okay, now we're kind of getting close to Quaylag's half of the swamp. I'll do that part later.
Got that gross slimy texture on everything down here.
Yep. And I hope you enjoyed the 5 minutes of not being poisoned. More like 5 seconds, really.
Yeah.
Because,
gonna be poisoned again.
Yep.
But you'll be glad when you clear out this zone and don't have to be.
You do realize I'm going to be back here a lot to grind large titanite shards unless I find another source, right?
Oh dear. Oh, there's another
Well,
one.
It would have been really nice to just pick that up if I'd known. I didn't want to pick up any of the items while I wasn't recording. Okay, well, that leech actually dropped something. Thank you.
He dropped one, and there was another item over there.
Yeah, I see it. Trust me, I stared at it a whole hell of a lot when I was doing this. A sword that would scale oddly well off of Dex, but also requires a ridiculous amount of strength to actually use. So probably not going to be a thing in this run. Probably not really a thing unless you decide to do a strength Dex build and just don't really use all that much magic, I guess. Granted, given how much just base magic adjust this thing has, I suppose it would be viable to have only like 15 or 16 intelligence to use some of the soul arrows and magic weapon and magic shield. And just use those and then use this thing for the base magic adjust and not really worry about taking intelligence any higher than that. So yeah, I suppose that would be doable. Might try it. Some green titanite shards that, to be perfectly honest, I really, really don't need. Do you know how many of those that I got off of these friggin' leeches while I was hoping for large titanite shards? I think I have over 100 of these dang things. Not even gonna bother trying to hit these ones with a spear because they're way too high up. And we're just gonna be immediately poisoned again, so we're gonna head back towards the bonfire. Hoping to lock onto him, game. Thank you. Oh god, he caught up to me. I was getting ready to try to get out of the way, and well, there we go. Go grab that, and then probably get ready to explore the other part of the swamp near where Quaylag is. Soul arrows because they're too close. I really hate these things. Time to just accept being poisoned. That's where we initially climbed down into the swamp. a plank shield. Wonderful. Yay for me randomly rolling into walls. Occasionally it works.
Oh, hopefully this is better than a plank shield.
Watch this be a mimic.
I hope not, but you know.
20 humanities.
Eh, not bad.
Cool. Is there anything else? Ha ha! The Great Hollow.
Okay, then.
Okay, that's ringing some bells.
Sounds bad.
That's ringing like maybe, I don't know, maybe it's just because it sounds like it, but remember the Great Bed of Chaos, like the Bed of Chaos or something?
Oh.
That we need to not find for reasons that are really dumb.
I don't know if you
really
want to fight that yet.
Okay, we'll go that way in a minute.
I have no idea what it is, but if it's the Bed of Chaos, I
don't know.
You don't
I do not know for sure. I want to make that very clear. I don't know, but I don't know. For some reason, I'm just thinking maybe, and
I'd finish up everything you know you need to finish before going someplace like that.
Yeah.
Just to be safe.
Poisoned again. Joy of joys. Should be in close to where that one lady wants to pop out of a freaking pillar. I think it's the set that's a little closer to Quaaludes domain. One of those, I think. Which is going to be real fun because there's going to be those ogre things wanting to chuck boulders at me the whole freaking time, and I don't know if they can also hurt her or not. So, end result is I need to fight them, ideally, before I get too close to any of the pillars. Of course not. Oh, incoming.
One down. Stab him right in the back. Stab him right in the back. Keep. Yep, yep. Oh, no. And he's dead.
Hey, And everybody enjoy not being poisoned for all of 5 seconds. And there's the great club. A pretty good weapon, all things considered, and it'll probably be one of my favorites when I eventually do a strength build. But not for me this time.
Where are you going?
Okay, guys, come on.
We know you're there.
Poisoning for a minute. So I think I'm gonna be up here and not in the swamp for at least a moment. It's the last of the Estus.
Get him. He's gonna roll at you. And done.
I think there's another. Kind of hard to see. I honestly might want to try that light sorcery and see how effective it is. Yep, there he is. Well, if he's not going to turn around... Oh, okay. He has a sliver of health left. Great. I thought he was done. He wasn't. Oh, cool. Also a mosquito, because why not?
Because this game just has to send a bunch of enemies at you.
Get around him so that I can actually stab there. And mosquito. Really should switch back to the light ones. There we go. Oh, but the love.
Another one?
Okay.
Another one? Really?
I would really like to have a conversation with an NPC in a moment and not have a bunch of things trying to hit both of us. Thanks.
Any more?
We done?
Are we finished? For...
Thanks. Okay, yeah, I see you. Eat some moss. And yeah, I think there she is. Another Archtitanite shard, thank you very much. Alright, weapons. There. Now, even if I somehow hit the friggin' triggers, I should do pretty much nothing.
A mere undead, yet you can see me. Fascinating. I am Quelana of Izalith. I am not often revealed to walkers of flesh. You have a gift. Are you too one who seeks my pyromancy, like Salomon?
Yes.
Yes, of course. It should be expected. Very well. You shall be my pupil. But to pursue my pyromancy, you must give something up. Are you prepared to do this?
Okay, let's see.
Long ago, I accepted another pupil like yourself. Over 200 years ago, there was a man almost as bungling as you. In your world, he was called Saloman, the Master Pyromancer. The little rascal really made something of himself. Pyromancy is the art of invoking and manipulating fire. But remember one thing. Always fear the flame, lest you be devoured by it and lose yourself. I would hate to see that happen again. Pyromancy, but remember...
So you don't have anything else to say on that for now. Alright, so you can ascend my pyromancy flame. I just need to bring you 25k souls. Okay. And I can buy another set of fire orbs. Great fireball, firestorm, fire whip, another set of combustion, great combustion.
Undead rapport.
Advanced pyromancy with Mana of Azalith. Charm undead and gain temporary allies. Okay. Alright, well, you know what? I have a crap ton of soul items.
Well, young pupil, you must have patience, but do not keep me waiting much longer.
So, you know what I don't want to have to come back and do a whole lot? Turn up with her here, fight off all those ogre things, because of course they couldn't put her just a little further back, where you didn't have to fight 3 million things to get to her and somehow have her not die. No, let's just put her right where it's freaking inconvenient. Well, anyway, time to use these things, not the unique souls. I think you can do other things with those.
You can do a lot with them.
So, our soul of a brave warrior. Yep. Use. Soul of a brave warrior.
There you go. And then you got a lot of these large souls and stuff.
Okay, so you can't use more than one at a time, so we're going to be doing this for a minute.
Yep. And then you can buy cool pyromancy stuff.
Alright, let's see how far along that gets me.
Ah, there you are. I was expecting you. Let us begin.
Another set of fire orbs seems good. Great fireball seems wonderful. I would like to try fire whip. And I would like to try all of these. I'll even do another bit of combustion because it is useful against the things that I mainly grind for souls against. So hey, undead rapport, I'm honestly not sure what exactly that's gonna do, but... Okay, so to get Firestorm, that's going to be 30k, and then 40k, like, because another 10k for Fire Whip, and then... So we're looking at, like, 55k souls if I want to get these last few.
Plus whatever it takes to ascend.
Plus to ascend, which is going to just be a lot.
Now, whatever you do, do not crack and go hollow. Lest my time spent on you be wasted.
Okay.
Okay, we're gonna unequip the fire bombs, and I'm gonna see if you can just equip the souls and use them that way.
Yep. Well, that'll make this go quicker.
That'll at least let me get Fire Whip. I don't think we have enough soul items to get the other ones. I'm honestly not that interested in Undead Rapport, so that's just going to be something that I get if I come here and I have extra.
Yeah, I would ascend before getting that. Your diligence.
But what have you brought for me?
Oh, so many souls. Again. Wouldn't mind getting Great Combustion, seeing if that makes the soul grinding go faster, so I think we have enough to grab that, too.
Pyromancy is the
upper... I was just seeing if you had anything else to say, since I'd bought some things.
Whatever you do, do not crack and go hollow, lest my time spent on you be wasted.
Let's see, now we're down to a lot of just the smaller souls.
Applaud your diligence.
So yeah, I do not have enough items to get another 30k, I don't think. So I'll come back for that and try it.
How much is it going to cost for you to ascend? Like,
to ascend?
Yeah.
We are looking at 25k, and then I think it can go to like plus 5 from there. Which is probably going to get more expensive each time.
Okay, so a lot of soul grinding for that.
A lot of soul grinding, and like I said, I'm probably going to have to grind for some more large titanite shards anyway. And I mean, the leeches don't give you a bunch of souls, but they do give you some, so I might get some from that, but I'm probably just going to go back up to that part of Dark Moon Garden where I'm fighting the sorcerer and the thief and the cleric over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. And that's just going to be an evening for me. Anyway, we are out of Estus flasks. I was kind of hoping that I'd get another humanity while I was running around in this swamp. I'm going to say at this point we should probably go for Quelaag, but we're going to need to rest first. And I'm thinking if we should kindle the bonfire, because if I run around here while human, I should get invaded by Milfred the Maneater, so I can fight her. And then I can just summon her for Quelaag. Win the easy way. Why not? Thoughts? Opinions?
I would just do it that way.
Because I blundered into that by accident last time, so may as well use one humanity sprite just so I can kindle this thing.
Might as well get the game to give you mercy where you can, because...
Honestly, given how often they say that they don't want you to go hollow and all of that, I do kind of wonder if maybe at some point in this game's development there was going to be a, like, you could actually like go nuts, like if there were going to be more stages to hollowing than just,
or a bad hollow game over.
Yeah, I don't know, something like that. Yep, there's... Oh, Mildred. Not Milfred. Meh. Screw it. Close enough. Alright. Magic weapon. And come on.
Come on. Okay. Stab. Okay. You win.
Yeah, we get more humanity than we spent to trigger that, so that was part of the reason I was okay with it. Would have been nice if I just picked up the extra one to kindle anyway, but eh. I suppose if I thought of it, I don't know if you always get a lick with humanity from that, or if that's just luck that I currently have one, so I don't know, maybe I could have gotten away without using a humanity item there, but eh. Alright, so now, assuming I can make it to Quaylag without dropping dead. What's this thing? Which, I mean, is a bit of an assumption on account of the fact that I'm gonna have to fight my way past the trolls again. Of course it just got me. Of course it did. And we'll explore up there after we're done fighting Quaylag and done with some other stuff. So that's how I intend to get out of here.
And why those things?
But yeah, I don't
know.
Please
don't get burnt.
If I don't find another way of getting to that item, then when I come down here probably to kill a bunch of leeches and talk to Quilana, that's probably when I will try to just go up to the other bonfire we started at and just leap repeatedly and see if it's possible to get down to that item from up there, like if that's how you're supposed to do it, because I can't think of any other ways currently. All right, now that we're out of the swamp, let's end the poisoning. Then back to Estus Flasks, because otherwise anything else is just asking for problems. You know, come to think of it, I should have attuned Flash Sweat. Would have helped with the fire damage, but we'll figure it out. All right. You just keep her distracted. There was the kaboom attack. I was just waiting for that. There we go.
Victory. No more Chaos Witch.
And of course, I'm pretty sure that's going to mean that I can't get humanity anymore by fighting the leeches and such, so. Like I said, though, that one merchant in the aqueduct sells humanity for 5k souls a pop, so worst case, I'll buy it there. Any more hidden walls? Here. Honestly wondering if I should just roll into literally every wall I see. Well, let's ring this bell.